everyone. Welcome back to In the House podcast with Jenny and Tony. Thanks for joining us.
Yes. Welcome back, Tony.
Thank you.
Oh my God, I haven't seen you in like a month and a half when you were pregnant.
I know, I really missed you
pretty
guys.
Much giving birth on this table here.
I was not at my best. Thank you for still having me on the podcast.
But you're minus one now.
I am minus one now.
Congratulations.
Thank you. But I'm not sleeping though, so I'll try and be as eloquent as possible.
What's her name?
In today's episode, Stevie Rose.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you. It's different.
So baby number two.
Yep.
And how is it the second time around?
You know what? It's actually easier. I don't want to jinx it. It's easier this time around.
Okay. Because you're not as worried, or is it just the baby's easier?
That's a great question. I think it's because it's a bit of both. So the pregnancy and the labor was a little bit easier than the first time around. And also, she's very calm. Mm-hmm. But it could also be that she was born early, and so it might not be completely representative of what her personality and how if she's going to be an easy baby is actually going to be, because normally when they're a little bit early they sleep a lot more and you don't get to know them as much yet.
Yeah.
So we'll see. But she has started revealing a little bit more. She's been crying every night and eating every hour. So,
and she could be vocal like her mama.
She's, yeah, very vocal. If she gets that from me, then I don't know what I'm in for. It's going to be tough. It's going to be tough when she's a teenager. But today's episode, we have an interesting one.
Oh yeah, let's get on with it.
Okay. And yeah. Actually, no, I not yet.
Okay.
What have you been up to? Because I haven't seen you in so long. Mm-hmm. You look amazing. It looks like you're very well rested, but you've been working a lot.
I have, mm-hmm. You know, without being able to travel, you just pick up more projects and more work because you just want to keep yourself busy.
Yeah.
And I normally would not pick up this much amount of work. But my team has been doing phenomenal.
Amazing.
Honestly, they're amazing. So doesn't seem like they've been mentally affected by the pandemic. Mm-hmm. We've been keeping contact with each other almost daily. Mm-hmm. And we've just actually did our team event in August.
I saw.
Yeah.
I liked the there was video and pictures on a boat.
Yeah.
And so that was fun.
Normally I surprise them with like a team event, and first year we did like a helicopter ride.
Ooh, that's
up
fun.
To Golden Ears, and uh-huh. we did some snowshoeing, and then second year we did some horseback riding at Pemberton.
Oh,
so
that's
this
great.
Year we went to Bowen Island on a boat, and yeah, that was, it was super fun. Just a day out, you know.
What was your favorite trip with the team so far? Because those are all really interesting experiences.
They're all so good, and oh gosh, probably the helicopter ride, just because
it's so different.
It's different, right? and I don't think the boys have ever done a helicopter ride either.
Was it scary?
Oh no.
No.
Okay. But you're asking the wrong person, because I love thrills, right?
Have you gone skydiving?
Four times.
Okay, I've only gone once. Mm-hmm. I loved it. It was fantastic, but it was so long ago, and now with the two kids, I'm like, I'm not going. It's not happening.
Can't
until they're
it.
Adults, no.
Yeah,
yeah.
You'll be jumping out with them.
Oh my gosh, I don't want them to do it either. That sounds like such a mom thing to say. Actually, maybe, we'll see. Today's episode is Health is Wealth. I love that. How is your success affected when you are and you are not on top of your health? Mm-hmm. And I think, we've had a lot of time to reflect on this because we are 8 months in of what we call social distancing. Mm-hmm. And even though it's a bit more relaxed in our city, it doesn't necessarily mean that people still don't feel isolated or lonely.
Mm-hmm. Because everybody's tolerance of social distancing is
different,
so
too.
Different.
Yeah. Absolutely. Some people are not going out at all. Some people are out all the time. And then there's the people in the middle that are comfortable sometimes. It kind of depends. Mm-hmm. And pandemics obviously can be stressful. We realize that COVID-19 may be stressful for people. And some people have had fear and anxiety due to uncertainty of the future, especially with young children. Mm-hmm. Kids just went back to school couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
And I know that was a stressful time for a lot of parents. Coping with stress in a healthy way right? Mm-hmm. Will make you and the people that you care about and your community stronger. So that's kind of the essence of today's episode. Stress during an infectious disease outbreak.
Mental health. So far, I just find there's so many outlets for me just because I
tell us about the outlets.
So many different
for sure
things.
So how are you then, what kinds of things are you doing to help with your mindset and your stress levels?
Being very habitual with my meditation.
So
my yoga has actually shut down, so unfortunately they couldn't survive
paying
the lease.
Which one did you go to, or what was the company?
Moto Yoga in Burnaby.
I loved that one.
Yeah, but that couple shut down.
Oh no, I didn't know. I hadn't been going because I couldn't do, it's hot yoga there, right?
Yeah.
I couldn't do hot yoga while I was pregnant, so I wasn't going.
Yeah, so I don't know if they were probably not doing too, you know, making too much anyways. Mm. I mean, they're just like a community builder, but they posted recently that they have to shut down because
it's sad.
It's taking a little bit too long for them to get back together, bringing back people into their studio.
Well, I know that a lot of other local businesses, if they're, especially if they're, you know, in health industry where there's social distancing and they're doing activities that are indoors, they have to take other things into account now. And obviously certain service industries too, like restaurants, those kinds of things. Or businesses that historically have been based on congregating in person in large events that haven't transferred over into, you know, Zoom meetings or social media or anything like that, that can be a struggle too.
How does this relate to someone's success in their business?
The mindset and keeping positive.
The mental health.
Well, I think you said something important. So you had said that you have a few outlets. One of them was meditation. So now that your yoga place has shut down, what kinds of things are you doing in your everyday routine then? Or how do you counteract that? Are you just doing it on your own? Do you time block time for that to have that just for yourself?
Well, luckily my gym has reopened. So we have obviously all the protocols in place in there. But I've always been a fan of the gym. Going about 5 days a week anyways, and I picked up a couple of new sports this
I saw a cool picture
really
of
productive.
You
productive.
Yeah,
like more than anything, I think I've actually picked up more sports, picked up more work, and started this podcast with you. I've just been really busy and being in my strength zone, as Colabina had said.
You're busy in a meaningful way.
Yeah,
you're doing things that are filling your cup. Okay.
How about you? Like, obviously you were pregnant during COVID, and now do you have to go do like some doctor trips back and forth into the hospital?
Yeah, I've only been out actually, so the only times I've been out, because my baby's only, she's not even a month old, actually, as we're filming this. I've only been out for doctor's appointments. I did go out on one real estate appointment a week and a half after. But I had a C-section, so that you're not really supposed to do that. And I, after that, stopped doing any appointments because I started bleeding again. Sorry, graphic on the podcast, but it's true. You have to put your health first. And since we're talking about health and being productive, I was feeling really good. I didn't think I would have any issues, but then I ended up making the recovery a little bit longer. So I stopped doing that. So I've mostly been home. We go out for doctor's appointments, but it's challenging for us having a new baby. She was technically born preemie actually too. So we have to be careful with having her. We would have to be careful having her around a lot of people regardless of whether or not there was social distancing and COVID. But the challenge mostly is that it's not as it typically is when you have a baby and you're introducing the baby to your friends and family. That's very different. So we've mostly just been home. And then with the fires and the smoke and everything too, I would like to take her outside, but there's so much smoke and she has really young lungs and we haven't been doing that. So I'm getting a bit of cabin fever at home. This is the first time that, other than the one real estate appointment, and I did go to the office to sign some checks and stuff, but that was just, you know, in and out.
Yeah.
And someone dropped me off there and took me back home. So this is the highlight of my month.
Your product
being out.
And you're posting, you're working on your laptop as you're feeding your baby and cradling her.
It takes longer to do certain things because I'm not going on the in-person appointments, but I'm still working behind the scenes, mm-hmm. it does take longer because you can only type with one hand, right? So you have the baby there, you type with one hand.
How are you taking care of yourself?
Well, I'm really lucky and fortunate though, because my husband David is, he's very supportive, mm-hmm. And he is at home with me helping. Mm-hmm. So I think that I'm fortunate because obviously I'm not doing it on my own. We also have a really great support network of intermediate family, extended family, and really close friends too. Mm-hmm. Right, I mean, they're not we're not physically seeing all of them, but we've had some really great friends drop off food because, you know, and we didn't ask them to. They're just great, great, very thoughtful friends that have done that for us, because I'm, again, running on no sleep. So if I'm not eloquent during the podcast today, I've probably for the whole week slept 7 hours.
And you're
the whole
today.
Week. Yeah, you're so you guys are going to have to bear with me.
What would you say, is there anything that you feel has affected, because you keep saying, mm-hmm. I'm not as eloquent. I mean, you sound fine to me.
I'm just really tired.
Do you feel like you're not able to put sentences together or put thoughts together?
It's slow.
Because it's slow. Sounds fine to me.
Oh, I'm glad that it sounds okay. No, it's just that it's just a little bit slow. You know, when you're thinking and normally you don't have to think so hard. Mm-hmm. I'm trying really hard to think right now, if I'm being honest. It was interesting though, during COVID, actually, if we can go back there for a minute, because you said, what was it like being pregnant during COVID? It was interesting because we had some clients, like everybody's threshold for being around people right now is different. And we've had to adjust with that. So we've switched, like I had mentioned previously, to a lot of online appointments or video telephone calls where we normally would go in person all the time. Mm-hmm. But being a pregnant woman during that pandemic, I found that a lot of other people were more concerned about my health, right? Because nobody really, we don't know too much, I guess, about the virus. Yeah. We know what we've been told. Mm-hmm. And the one thing that was really difficult and impactful was the switching of the doctor's appointments to telephone or online, because there are certain things you can't test for when you do that. So for, in my case, you know, our first podcast episode where we were filming, well, I looked terrible in that. I had the eye infection. I was feeling really crummy. It was because we didn't catch the gestational diabetes that was really bad. Mm-hmm. So I feel like for a lot of other people, possibly, even if you're in good health, not having access to certain healthcare practitioners, like, you know, I don't know, dietitian, nutritionist, acupuncturist, that can have an effect mm-hmm. on people's productivity and how they're doing their everyday routines. Mm-hmm.
What are some outlets someone can, how can they take care of themselves so that they are at their peak?
I think so. I only know that I've been trying, and I don't have it all worked out. For me, the biggest thing is rest. Mm-hmm. And I associate rest with self-care, but not in the way like I'm being pampered or anything. It's just, you need to sleep.
Yeah, yeah. It's just so, the simple things, right?
Yeah. Even something as simple right now, it's going to sound gross, everyone, but I don't get to shower all the time. Because the baby's cluster feeding every hour while I'm sometimes trying to work from home. Mm-hmm. And that's a lot too. And so I'm not showering all the time. To have a warm shower, it is so loving. And it feels great, and you feel so nice after.
Simple pleasures.
I know, right? And that's what, when we had Connie Buna mm-hmm. on as a, and we were interviewing her, she had said too, simple pleasures. Like, it's not that difficult. So you have to take care of yourself, of course. And I think that that can definitely help with team management, productivity, abundance, mm-hmm. mindset, all mm-hmm. of these things that are so essential for a thriving business mm-hmm. and a thriving person. Mm-hmm. You said health is wealth.
Yeah, absolutely.
I wanted to ask you a question though. So actually it was more so delving into more detail about, so you said you have a lot of outlets that you're doing right now. Mm-hmm. Anything else specific rather than bringing on new activities and like physical, so you mentioned meditation, physical activity mm-hmm. and new outlets, learning new things.
The biggest epiphany for me is having a good circle around you.
Yeah, that's really important.
I think that really helped my mental boost mm-hmm. because just being around people who are very positive and optimistic about this really, really helped, because I'm generally a very positive person. And so for me to feel like I'm not in it alone, and for me to feel like I can share some of my thoughts and vulnerability to them, it actually brought a lot, my relationships closer.
That's good.
It actually allowed me to figure out who doesn't belong in my life.
Oh, that's really important.
It's a great way to like declutter my like phone book, but also just, you know.
Do these people know that you decluttered them from your phone book?
They'll find out soon.
Okay. Who's calling me?
Or just keeps ringing.
Actually, so when the whole pandemic thing started and there was more self-distancing in place, did you notice that it had an impact on you, on your initial mindset? And is that why you've kind of really dialed in to your daily routine and what's important to you for having those outlets to remain productive, I guess?
It made me a lot more aware of actually my intentions of every action. So I would just go on my day and it would be packed with full of tasks.
Like you're a zombie walking through the day?
And it was more just like, okay, I got this done, got that done, and then I'm on to the next appointment. So it's everything is all like a fast motion picture. Versus with COVID, you know, nothing's open, and so you're sitting down and you're actually dissecting all those tasks, breaking it down, and really asking, I actually asked myself, are these tasks even important?
I heard you say that before.
And so what is the meaning behind it? Is it actually that big of a deal to make more work than I have to? And so it actually allowed me to clear my mind a little bit on what kind of impact I want to make on a bigger scale.
I think that's great. Well, what about now? Would you say that your daily, I'm sure most people's daily routines have changed. I know that mine has. What is your daily routine looking like now? And how does it impact your business? Or how do you fit all of these things in that you need to complete?
So one big change was where I live. So where I was living, I was really isolated. There was no one around. And I'm really big on like nature and water. So I decided to move out of Burnaby into Vancouver and be really close to the water. So my walks in the mornings and at nighttime, especially with my dog, has been really helpful, and being able to meet new people.
Are there lots of people going out for a walk still now? I'm inside with the baby, so I don't know.
Like parks are packed, beaches are packed. That's where everybody's hanging out because nothing else is open.
I mean, it's great to get back into nature. It can be very soothing.
And healing. Lots of hikes. Yeah. And what was your second part of the question?
What your daily routine is looking like at now, I guess. And I guess the second part of the question would be, how does that daily routine that you have implemented maximize your work week or work day? Work day.
I would probably say using my time a lot wiser. So leveraging all the tasks where I don't need to be doing it and I'm willing to let go. And kind of reconsidering exactly why I'm doing it. Because I think what happened during COVID was, what is the meaning of life for me?
I think it was for a lot of people the same question they were asking themselves.
Right, and I feel like that's really connected with my mental health, because if I'm just like going into down to these little details that don't really matter, wanted just to remove that out of my life.
So and then you want to create something that's meaningful and impactful and purposeful to you.
Yeah, absolutely.
In every facet of your life.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's great.
So that's how I kept like healthy and infused work-life balance. I don't like to use the word balance, but
just very imbalanced at times.
Yeah, use it together so that I can enjoy more of the type of work that I want to do.
Did you notice, because the topic is obviously health is wealth and doing certain things that can promote good health. Did you notice during the last 8 months that other people were not possibly faring as well as you in terms of, you know, mindset and doing creative, positive things for your own, like for your own life that would set you up for success? Did you notice that other people were treating it a bit differently?
Yeah, I just actually had a conversation while I was paddleboarding with a buddy of mine, and he was mentioning he turns on, he records the news on his PVR.
Oh, to fast forward through some of the stuff?
Well, and he's like, yeah, every time I go, before I go to bed, I listen to the news. And I'm like, why would
that's
you
hard.
Want to inject yourself with toxic news that's happening around the world that may not directly affect you, will affect you, but there's no way you can change it. That's one way I found. I was like, why? I guess I don't have a TV and I don't really read a lot of news. Mm-hmm. So I didn't really understand why you would gravitate to that mm-hmm. channel to release, like, for the, especially at the end of the day. You don't want to be thinking about any of that stuff. But other people, yeah, absolutely. They missed home. They wanted to fly home. They couldn't see their family. Mm-hmm. They had children with them. So
yeah.
Being around their children actually 24/7 rather than being able to let them go to school or daycare,
yeah.
I think that affected them as well because they didn't have any alone time. I just spoke to someone today. They actually separated after being so close with each other during COVID.
But I think that's a good thing. No, I'm going to say why.
There's probably way more underlying issues beyond that.
Well, for me, and I know that we kind of talked about this before, maybe not on the podcast, but I think that it's a great time for opportunity. Mm-hmm. Because like you had done with your life, it's kind of like, what is purposeful? What is my intention? What's important to me? And how do I want it to affect my entire life on a larger, broader scale? Like, what's the big picture? I think that this was a great time for people to question, like really ask yourselves the hard question. Are you doing everything with your life that makes you happy? Are there things that you can change? Is there something that's not bringing you joy and fulfillment that you can actually change and fix so that mm-hmm. you do find joy and fulfillment in everyday life? So for me, I actually never saw it as a bad thing. That might be controversial, but I thought it was a blessing. And it's really interesting, the spectrum that I've observed with clients, friends, and colleagues on where they fall in terms of, you know, over the last 8 months, were they anxious? Did they feel isolated? Mm-hmm. Were they, you know, feeling joy? Were they just kind of doing new tasks or taking on new things to get through the time? More so that was in March, right? Mm-hmm. When there wasn't as many, when everything was closed. So yeah, that's the most interesting thing to me, is that I feel like some people have, with the lemons, made lemonade, and other people have not really mm-hmm. found where they want to be.
Right. I want to give some tips on how to have a more resilient mindset, because
we've
got to protect that brain of ours and protect our health mm-hmm. in order to continue living.
Mine are pretty simple. Mm-hmm. There are simple things that I do that help me. I don't know if it would help other people, but I find, especially with having the new baby and everything too, I do require at least 5 or 10 minutes of my thinking time. That's really important to me. And it's something that really rejuvenates me. Mm-hmm. It just resets my entire mindset so that I can refocus. And if I don't sit quietly doing nothing, it doesn't even have to be meditation, I can't sort through information properly. Mm-hmm. So for me, to have that resilient mindset, I do a few things. One of them would be meditation. Like you had mentioned, you do that yourself. Mm-hmm. Another is journaling and completing affirmations. Mm-hmm. For some reason, that just really works for me. It's kind of like having a brain dump all on paper, getting it all out of the way so that I don't have to take up negative space in my brain, and then it's just kind of out there. And then the affirmations are, so for example, if I'm thinking something negative, or if I find myself going down a negative thought process, it's like switching it completely the opposite way. I'll either write something that's the exact opposite of what came through my mind right then, and then I'll just do the affirmations on paper for that. I find that that's helpful. And then another one would be, I guess, a bit of self-care. I don't have a lot of that right now. Mm-hmm. Mostly it's sleep or rest mm-hmm. for self-care. Do you have similar things that you utilize for positive mindset resilience, or do you employ mm-hmm. other mechanisms to help you?
I've always been a person who, if there's something that I'm having to confront, I'm like, bring it on. I'm like,
yeah, it's the best.
I embrace it and I'm gonna maneuver around it. I accept anything that's not in my control.
That's sometimes hard for people to do.
I don't think
I struggled with that for a long time.
I don't think there's many people that I know of anyways that will actually invite that. And I actually invite it because that pushes me to another level of challenge.
I have a question about that. Mm-hmm. So accepting what you cannot control, is that the same or similar to being unattached to the outcome? Or is that something mm-hmm. different? I'm just curious. I think that it might vary a little bit.
To a degree, you would hope that the outcome would come out positive, of course, because what else would you want it to come out as? Mm-hmm. I don't expect it I don't think I have any expectations.
Okay.
I just face it and I'm like, let's problem solve this.
Yes.
And see whatever happens. And I feel like because of my positive efforts,
yes,
it just turns it always out works the out way the way it is.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I can get down with that. I can. I like finding creative solutions to problems that present themselves.
And it's all how you respond and react to it.
But that's the thing, it's like don't react. This is what it is. Try and fix it doing these things, or things that are not the things that maybe haven't been utilized in the past. You might get a different result.
Do you have an exact example?
I can give one.
Yeah.
Okay, so an example of being unattached to the outcome, or an example of a creative solution. Mm-hmm. Okay, one would be, for example, in our business. Sometimes in real estate, if it's concerning a certain real estate deal, for example, there might be something that comes up that is completely out of your control. So that's the first thing. Okay, out of your control. But there's still something there where you need to find a resolution. We just had this real estate client mm-hmm. Who was a downsizer, and we had never done business with them before. Mm-hmm. But we had taken the meeting. This was actually the last listing that I took right before I went into labor. So it was like a couple days before. But we met with the seller and they had all kinds of fears about, you know, downsizing to something that was more manageable for them. They had raised their family in this home for 30 some plus years. So there was a lot of emotional attachment to the property and memories with and decluttering that needed to happen in that actual home. But there were three or four things that needed to happen before these people could actually get exactly what they wanted. It was selling for top dollar, but they needed a certain price, obviously, in order to make it happen. And it needed to be so exact that it couldn't be even $25,000 off. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that was the first hurdle. Second one was that they also needed to find something that they could purchase, which would be their last real estate investment purchase, going in with that mindset, long-term investment, mm-hmm. that would suit their needs. So for example, something flat, no stairs. I'm just relating it to real estate because we're talking about real estate.
Yeah, yeah.
In an area that they love, being close to their friends and family that they also love. Now, in order for the plan to work, they needed to be sold mm-hmm. at a certain price. Mm-hmm. It couldn't even be, like, you couldn't be off at all or else the plan wouldn't work because, you know, sometimes people have to discharge mortgages. They also require funds to purchase the next place, but don't forget, they're retiring.
Yeah.
So you can't get a mortgage,
yeah.
right? I mean, there's different ways that you could do it.
Yeah.
It was presenting them with a creative marketing plan to achieve selling their home for top dollar, which we were able to achieve, and also timing it perfectly so that they would mm-hmm. purchase within that time frame and only have to move the one time. Mm-hmm. And so that they could net more than $350,000 into savings so that they could travel. Now, there were three or four things, if they didn't happen during that entire the entire marketing plan, if one of the three or four things didn't happen, their plan wasn't going to happen. So in order to find creative solutions to make that happen, one, you have to think outside of the box with marketing. Two, you have a different plan that you're going to put into place that's going to make it work. Mm-hmm. But actually, first and foremost, it's having the mindset and creating that opportunity for them where all these three or four things are actually going to work out mm-hmm. and we're not going to encounter a problem. Mm-hmm. But then the creative solutions just happen. So it's one, create the path for allowing everything that needs to happen to work out. Mm-hmm. Two, creating that plan that's actually going to work and still not getting in the way mentally with what happens if, oh, what happens if this happens, or we didn't get the offer on it, or there was also challenges with the sale of their home that I won't mention. But does that make sense, or is that just more confusing?
No, it does.
Okay,
well, so for me, because
how can we articulate that better for the listeners? Because I told you that I'm not sleeping right now. I'm just giving you an example of what had just happened, but I don't know if it's actually clear, because for me saying it, it doesn't seem clear right now. How can we sum it up? Oh, the end result was obviously that we were successful in everything. They sold their house for highest value in their area, which is not necessarily due to anything that we did. We just allowed it to happen, but we're not responsible for the market. It just that happened. Mm-hmm. And they purchased within 2 weeks as well for their dream home in a fantastic build that I don't foresee any problems in. And it allowed them to be close to their family. Plus, they don't have to worry about finances. I mean, what more do you want? That's great. Because now it's really allowed them to spend time with friends and family without having that financial stress. Does that make sense? That was the outcome. And they're happy, which makes me happy.
That's good.
Yeah.
Everything worked out.
It did work out.
I also feel like you stayed focused with the bigger picture. What is the end result of?
Well, the end result was getting them something that they wanted to truly be happy, that was going to be a long-term investment for them.
Yeah.
And also,
it worked out.
Yeah.
How about connecting with others that are like-minded? I think that's a really, really big component of surrounding yourself. Actually, I do want to do a shout out. I think we should do a
shout out
because in this room, we're connected with some really good people.
Oh, I love them so much.
Especially, we have Miranda M. Mantle Design.
Yeah.
She's been part of my life for like 3 years, I'd say. She just actually passed her 3-year anniversary, 4-year anniversary.
Wow, congratulations, Miranda. Oh, okay.
No, our work marriage.
Oh, I got it, got it. Her face is red right now because she doesn't like the shout out, but she 100% deserves
on the West Coast team.
Yeah.
And we got the Podfather creative.com, Brayden.
How do you say your last name?
Wait, I'm going to try it.
Drakowski?
Drakowski.
No, it's not.
Dikowski.
Really
Dikowski. I did ask earlier.
Did you?
Yeah.
I didn't. That's why I said dry. I'm like, I threw an R in there.
Did you check out his website? He just started.
Yes, I got the link.
FatherCreative.com.
Yeah.
Everybody check him out because he's
been fantastic.
Doing a fantastic job for us. We just sound great because of him.
We do. I mean, the audio sounds great. I can't help what I'm saying right now. There's no way to edit it out.
But connecting with others, I think just surrounding yourself with people who
are
like-minded,
people, for sure.
Who can problem solve and who will weather life storms.
Do you know how you said that it speaks to exactly what you're talking about?
Yeah.
You know how you said that you had you were decluttering your phone and I asked you if those people knew?
Yeah.
And we just said, surround yourselves with positive, like-minded people.
Mm-hmm.
So the reason I asked you that is because there's nothing more fulfilling than letting go of people that are negative Nellies. But the difference is that I will tell them that we will no longer be in communication.
Really?
I'm like, did these people know that you deleted them?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. I don't think I need to explain.
No, not if we don't talk to them all the time.
No,
but I mean,
I don't talk to them all the time.
Oh, okay. So I mean even like cutting people out where they normally would have been in your life, but they're negative. Oh, okay, I see.
No, I think they just notice.
That's fine. That's a bit different.
I don't respond. There's no positive impact in my life.
Mm-hmm.
But who's been like your number one rock in your life besides your husband? Is there any?
Oh yeah, my mom.
Your mom? Yeah.
I mean, we're a really close family. So actually it would be my mom and my dad. Oh shoot, I can't pick just one because I do feel really, really fortunate. So kind of like what we had said here, I mean, we're working with Brayden and Miranda. We both work with our own real estate teams.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fortunate to work with every single one of them. I don't take it for granted. And the only way that I can do that is by having that support network in my personal sphere.
Mm-hmm.
So my mother-in-law too, they're all very supportive. I feel like, gosh, I'm a lucky girl, and there's nothing else that I could ask for in the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have a great support team.
Yeah, so I think
my best friend Herb, he's been in my life for about 16, 17 years.
Herb, does he live here?
He lives locally.
Oh, locally.
Yeah,
okay.
He's probably
in Vancouver.
My only friend family that I have here because
really,
Otherwise, all my family members are back east and back in down in California.
When are you going back there, by the way?
As soon as possible.
I know, you must miss them a lot. That's hard.
It's possible I can go.
But then you have to isolate here for 2 weeks, which you can. You can do Zoom calls.
Yeah, I guess I can. That's a good excuse.
You could do Zoom calls. You should go and see them. What else do we have about the minds on your mindset agenda right there?
That's it. I think one of the things I want to mention is nutrition.
Oh yeah, please do.
Let's talk about that.
Let's talk about nutrition.
Just a quick, like, what are you taking? Mm-hmm. Are you taking supplements? What are you eating in your diet?
Yeah.
I think that's really important to, especially as a realtor, I'm always eating nuts in the car, not really eating proper meals.
A lot of people in sales say the same thing. Mm-hmm. So real estate sales, any other type of sales, they're kind of on the road a lot. So the first thing that gets neglected is their nutrition, or they're going to grab a fast food burger because they're out, but they're starving and they haven't planned properly. Mm-hmm. I agree. And I'm glad that we're talking about this because everyone does relate to being healthy and being your most productive self. How are you supposed to be your most productive self? Okay, if we were doing a challenge right now, the challenge would be how to be your most healthy and successful self, both in life and in your business.
Okay, we gotta narrow it down even more.
Okay.
Like an action plan, that's very abstract.
Okay.
And it's very vague so we gotta do an actual action.
60 days to ultimate health.
Okay. Now let's break it down to daily.
60 days to ultimate health, and so daily.
What's our daily
requirements?
Yeah, that we're going to keep each other accountable.
Okay, my schedule is not great right now.
I don't want to hear excuses.
No, it's not an excuse.
Because if I see you on the laptop,
it's not an excuse.
And then you're not actually working on the challenge.
Those of you that know me for real know that I don't make excuses. I will take accountability for it. But I was going to say, because of the schedule, I also have to create for myself mm-hmm. Goals that I can meet, mm-hmm. okay. right? So I don't know if this is good enough.
We'll try. No, we'll make it easy.
Okay.
We'll make it doable.
Okay. So for me, a big one is not skipping meals.
Okay.
But I really can't because I also am breastfeeding right now. And
that's
in
good.
Order to keep the breast milk up, you have to have regular meals.
Okay, so you're accountable for yourself and for Stevie.
That's right. And of those regular meals, at least 3 of the meals need to be real food.
Write that down.
She wants me to be healthy, folks.
Okay, my challenge.
Okay.
I need to sleep better.
Yeah, you definitely do.
I'll go to bed 2 o'clock. No,
5 a.m. 2 hours before you had to get ready for work.
I know, it's probably gonna catch up to me one day, but.
I told you, that's what happened to me.
Rather than a time, I'd rather maybe just say X number of hours in a day, in a 24-hour period, because maybe I could take take naps.
No,
that doesn't count.
There's research that says that you need proper REM sleep. You don't enter proper REM, and I'm not a scientist, but I know a little bit about sleep.
Okay.
So there's a difference though. Make the plan for how many consecutive hours that you're going to sleep.
Okay.
And then you need action steps for how you're actually going to implement it.
Oh, that's easy for me to do. Once I sleep, I sleep.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that no problem falling asleep.
So the problem is what then? That you're just not allowing yourself to lay down and sleep?
I just keep working because I'm so excited about working.
Oh, there's nothing wrong with that. I get it though, because I do that too, so that's the problem.
Like,
I should not be advising you about this.
Once I'm on like this like rant of getting things out, I just keep going. So let's set a time.
So what's your number of hours?
I don't know, what is normal?
I don't know.
Like
I ran on like 2 to 3 hours sleep for many years. And then I had the worst health of life.
Miranda and Brayden are saying
what? Miranda, what is that? 8?
8 hours? That's
you said 7 because you have kids.
That's
7's a good day.
Hours.
Can I meet in the middle like 6?
I think 6 is great. I think 5, to be honest, I'm not just saying this. I think 5 or 6 hours is great because I also am someone that doesn't, in the past I hadn't slept a lot. I'd be really passionate about work, be replying to emails at like 3 a.m. But I also have kids now too, and they don't help with the sleep. So if I could do 5 or 6 hours a night, that would be golden.
Okay, I'm gonna do 6 hours. I feel like I would probably get some.
So what time are you turning in then? Because it's one thing
that's
to say
a
six.
Personal question. I'm joking.
No, I mean, you need to. What time are you shutting it off? This is for accountability.
Midnight? That's so early. Wow. Well, can we bring it down to 5 hours?
Yeah, it's your plan.
Yeah, 5 hours. 1 o'clock to 6 o'clock.
When are we checking in about this again? Is this a daily thing?
There's some apps that probably track your sleep, right? I'm sure there is.
Yeah,
there's tons of it.
Do you have an Apple Watch?
No.
Oh.
But I'll download an app.
Okay.
And I'll show it to you.
Well, no, I believe that if you tell me you're going to do something, you're going to do it. Just like when I tell you I'm going to do something, you should know that it gets done.
Okay, good.
You don't have to send it to me.
We should just...
Unless you think it'll help. You want to send it to me? You can. This actually has been very beneficial.
It's a very good session because I did not think I was going to do anything.
Yeah, and we were also, I guess, in need of better health. We were talking about wealth is health. Apparently, ours is not optimal.
We're going to optimize it for the next 60 days.
Okay.
Before the end of the year, we are going to eat better and we're going to sleep better.
We're going to share the results then at the end of the year with the listeners if you guys are still listening to us on this podcast. I don't know about me after today.
Well, thanks for listening, guys.
Thanks, everyone, for listening.
And we'll be back next week.
Yeah, and you know what? We've been getting some great feedback from realtor colleagues, both local and actually there are some people that reached out that are not within the Vancouver market.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're getting a lot of Torontarians.
Yes.
Is that the proper way to say it? Torontarians?
Yes. No.
American. No. Torontarians.
Torontonians.
Oh, is it really?
Torontonians. Getting a lot of Americans.
Yeah.
Followers.
So... the reason why we bring this up is, of course, and as always, if you give us feedback on these episodes for things that you want to see or hear about, topics that you would like us to cover, that will help us bring you the material that you want to hear more about, rather than us just formulating what we think we want, what we think people might want to hear about.
Which is just as important.
It is important.
We also want you to tune in.
But please reach out. Yeah.
And answer all the questions that you have about this business.
Yes, for sure. Okay. Well, I think that sums it up. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, guys.
Have a great day.
Bye.